Recently, there's been a lot of activity with Israel's Iron Dome, but what exactly is the Iron Dome and how does it work? Hey, it's Dan Zimmerman and welcome back to Illustrate to Educate. In this video, we'll look at the history of the Iron Dome and how Israel's missile defense system works. The Iron Dome is Israel's missile defense system with the aim of countering the increasing threat of short-range rocket attacks from neighboring territories, particularly the Gaza Strip. The need for such a system became evident during conflicts like the Second Lebanon War in 2006 and Operation Cast Lead in 2008-2009, where Israeli civilians were targeted by rocket fire from Hamas and other militant groups. Following these conflicts, the Israeli government accelerated efforts to develop a solution capable of intercepting and neutralizing these short-range rockets. The Iron Dome project began in 2007 with funding from the Israeli government and financial support from the United States. The system was developed in collaboration with several Israeli defense companies, including Rafael Advanced Defense Systems and Israel Aerospace Industries. After years of development and testing, the Iron Dome became operational in March 2011, initially deployed near the southern Israeli city of Beersheba. It was gradually expanded to other areas vulnerable to rocket attacks, including communities near the Gaza border and cities within range of rockets fired from Lebanon. Since its deployment, the Iron Dome has undergone continuous upgrades and improvements to enhance its capabilities and address evolving threats. These upgrades have included improvements to radar systems, interceptor missiles, and overall system efficiency. Now let's look at how Israel's missile defense system works, which includes the Iron Dome, David's Sling, and Arrow systems. The first part is detection and tracking. The Iron Dome, David's Sling, and Arrow systems rely on a network of radar stations to detect and track incoming threats. Each system has its own radar capabilities, allowing for comprehensive coverage of Israeli airspace. The second part is threat assessment. Once a threat is detected, the data is analyzed by a central command center. The threat is assessed based on its trajectory, speed, and potential impact areas. The third part is interception. Depending on the type and range of the threat, the appropriate defense system is activated. The Iron Dome is designed to intercept short-range rockets and artillery shells. The Iron Dome fires interceptor missiles to destroy incoming threats in midair. David's Sling handles medium to long-range threats, including ballistic and cruise missiles. It launches interceptor missiles equipped with advanced guidance systems to intercept and neutralize the incoming threats. Lastly, Arrow systems Arrow 2 and Arrow 3 are systems designed to intercept ballistic missiles outside the Earth's atmosphere. They launch interceptor missiles to destroy incoming threats before they reach their targets. The final part is coordination. The different defense systems are integrated into a unified command and control network, allowing for real-time communication and coordination. This ensures that threats are effectively intercepted and neutralized with minimal delay. Lastly, let's look at recent activity with the Iron Dome. Around midnight on April 13, 2024, Iran launched an attack in response to a suspected Israeli strike on the Iranian consulate in Damascus, Syria, a couple weeks prior. The recent attack from Iran consisted of a 5-hour barrage of more than 300 drones and missiles toward Israel. Between the Iron Dome and Israel's allied forces, such as the United States and the UK, the attack was thwarted and a reported 99% of missiles were deflected. This recent attack has marked a new chapter in a discord between Israel and Iran that has been ongoing for decades and recently escalated since Israel declared war on Hamas in October of 2023. Did you find this video about the Iron Dome to be helpful? If so, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to Illustrate to Educate to support more simple and objective videos on topics that matter. If you like this video, be sure to check out more videos on the channel.